I'm also going to bring up some of the demands that Black Lives Matter has been pushing for years now, which I think the fact that you're actually doing a meeting here and there in the community is representative of the fact that of the work that BLM has been doing. But to reiterate some of the things that have already been said about accessibility, it is ridiculous that it's on a Tuesday at 9:30 in the morning. It needs to be somewhere in the community where working people can afford to be able to go, schedule-wise.
There's no one watching him right now, not a single person.
Sir, when it's your turn to speak, come to the microphone. Yes. If you're going to speak from there.
So you can ignore him, too?
Yeah, focus. Right.
Lift up your head
and
focus.
Go ahead, Mr. Smith.
So they need to be accessible. There needs to be parking. We all can luckily afford parking, or we walk or take the metro. But you know, you all know, or maybe you don't, you probably don't know how ridiculous parking is cost-wise downtown.
No, they park under this building.
Right. And speaking further to accessibility, this morning President Soboroff said hi to me by name outside of the police department, which, you know, quite impressed. He asked me about my beautiful kids, which we blame on my beautiful partner, of course. But imagine if this meeting was actually accessible, how many members of the public you could actually do that to before these meetings. Not just the few of us that are able to come every time. I think one of the other BLM demands that's pertinent to this mission is about community representation. None of you actually represent the communities that are affected by LAPD policies.
Right.
And I think it'd be really brave and telling about how much you care about the community if one of you resigned and publicly asked Mayor Garcetti to appoint someone from these communities affected by LAPD.